Hello students, in this class we will see another new topic, that is surface tension. Okay, it is a property of liquid when the liquid is at rest. Okay, so first we will discuss the property of liquid at rest, so that is surface tension. Okay, so you all have seen few things in nature, like suppose you keep one piece of hair in water, then that hair will not enter inside the water. Few insects you have seen, in few insects they can easily walk on the surface, free surface of water. Okay, suppose a leaf is falling, is there on the surface of liquid, surface of water, then it will float on the surface of water. So these are few things which can be explained by this surface tension. Okay, it is basically intermolecular forces and very weak force. Okay, so first we will see the intermolecular forces, the nature of intermolecular forces and different kinds of intermolecular forces. Then I am going to in details of this surface tension. Okay, so first intermolecular forces. Okay, so intermolecular forces, there is a particular range. Within that range, intermolecular force will be attractive and after that it will be repulsive. Okay, so there is no particular attraction or repulsion. Okay, it depends on the range. Okay, in between the two molecules, if the distance between two molecules is under a certain range, then it will be attractive or repulsive, and beyond that certain range it will be either attractive or repulsive. So we will see in which case we will get attractive, in which case we will get repulsive force. Okay, so here the formula of this intermolecular force becomes like this: minus a by r to the power 7 plus b by r to the power 9. Clear? So here a, b are some constants and r is the distance between two molecules. Okay, so here we are seeing the first part is of negative nature and second part is of positive nature. Okay, so negative nature means this first part tells about the force of attraction. Okay, and the second part tells about the force of repulsion, because it is positive in nature. Clear? So there is no particular kind. Okay, it is a combination of attraction and repulsion. Okay, so we will see the range. Okay, within that range it will be attractive or repulsive, and beyond that range it will be opposite kind of nature. So we will see in which range it will be attractive and which range it will be repulsive. So at some distance, at some separation between the two molecules, the force will be zero, because two opposite kinds of quantities are there, right? One is positive, another is negative. So at some distance, at some value of r, we will get these two quantity, means F will be zero. That means there will be no force between the two molecules. Clear? So at which distance we will get this kind of situation? So suppose at that distance F equal to zero. At which distance F equal to zero? When R equal to, suppose R zero. Okay, this is the equilibrium position. Equilibrium means no force. There is no force. Okay, so minus A by R0 to the power 7 plus B by R0 to the power 9 equal to 0. So solve it, you will get what? A by R0 to the power 7 equal to B by R0 to the power 9. Okay, R0 to the power 7 and here 7 cancel out. So you will get only 2, R0 square. So you will get basically R0 square equal to B by A, or R0 equal to root over B by A. Okay, so this is the distance of equilibrium. Okay, when the distance between two molecules, suppose these are the two molecules, these are the two molecules, when the separation between the two molecules is R0, then there will be no force of attraction or repulsion between the two molecules. It will be the equilibrium condition. Okay, equilibrium condition means no force between the two molecules. So suppose r is greater than r0, then what will happen? And r is less than r0, then what will happen? Remember, here the distance between the two molecules is very very small. Okay, that means it is a decimal value. Okay, that means 0 point something. Okay, so I am coming to that point. So first case, when r is greater than r0, r is greater than r0, then what will happen? In this case, r is greater than r0, then force of attraction will dominate over the force of repulsion. Both the forces will be there, but one value of force of attraction will be greater than the value of force of repulsion. Clear? So when r is greater than r0, attractive force dominates. Okay, dominates over repulsive, and hence the resultant force will be attractive. Resultant force will be attractive. Okay, when r is greater than r0, attractive force dominates over repulsive force, and hence resultant force will be attractive. Okay, that means both the forces will be there, its value will be greater. Okay, attractive force value will be greater. Clear? Now come to the second point. So the second point is, when r is less than r0, r is less than r0, then what will happen? That means distance between the two molecules is less than the equilibrium distance between the same two molecules. Then what will happen? Repulsive component will dominate over attractive. Okay, and hence resultant force will be repulsive. Okay, resultant force will be repulsive. So these are the few cases between the intermolecular forces. Okay, now suppose I want to draw the graph of this force with distance, then how it will look like? So the graph will be like this. This is r and this is the force, and graph will look like this. Okay, clear? In this region, the resultant force is positive. Resultant force is positive force means repulsive. Okay, this point is r0. This point represents r0, equilibrium distance. So in this region, force will be repulsive. And after that, beyond r0, when r is greater than r0, then force has negative value. So force will be attractive. When the distance will be too much, distance between the two molecules is very large, then the attractive force will be very small. Okay, clear? So this will be the graph. Okay, now come to the types of intermolecular forces. So intermolecular force will have two types. One is force of cohesion, or you can tell cohesive force. What is this? Cohesive force is basically, it is the attractive force. Okay, attractive force between the molecules of same nature. Okay, attractive force between the molecules of same nature means, suppose the force of attraction between the molecules of water, okay, between the molecules of any other liquid, okay, that is force of cohesion. And second one is force of adhesion or adhesive force. Okay, force of adhesion or adhesive force. What is this? This is also the attractive force between the molecules of different nature. Attractive force between the molecules of different nature. Different nature. Clear? Clear? So you have seen this experiment, okay, that when you are putting your finger inside water, okay, then you bring your finger out, then you will see some water droplets are present in your finger, okay, some water droplets are present in your finger. That means in this case the force of attraction between the molecules of water and the molecules of your finger is greater than the force of attraction between the molecules of water only. That means here adhesive force is greater than the cohesive force. Clear? But if you put your finger inside mercury and then bring your finger out, then you will see there is no mercury droplet attached to your finger. That means in this case, when you are putting your finger inside mercury, then the force of cohesion, the force, attractive force between the molecules of mercury is greater than the force between the molecules of mercury and your finger. Clear? So when you are putting your finger inside water, then adhesive force is greater. And when you are putting your finger inside mercury, then cohesive force between the molecules of mercury is greater. Clear? So when adhesive force is greater, then any liquid will wet that kind of object, and when cohesive force is greater, then that liquid will not wet that object, okay, which object is we are putting that object inside, water or mercury or any other kind of liquid. Clear? And these forces are very weak forces. Basically cohesive and adhesive, both the forces are of van der Waals forces, you can tell, okay, van der Waals force, which is very weak force. Clear? Now come to the thing of surface tension. Okay? So now in the surface tension, first I am telling about the sphere of influence. Okay? Sphere of influence. Okay? Clear? What is this? So sphere of influence is basically a sphere. Okay? And how will you draw the sphere? Suppose it is a sphere. And at the center of that sphere, we will put a molecule of that liquid. Okay? Molecule of any liquid. Clear? And all the molecules, many molecules will be there in this sphere of influence. Okay? All the molecules will attract the molecules present at the center of sphere of influence. Clear? So, many molecules are there. I am taking the molecules only at the periphery, but many molecules are there inside this sphere. Okay? Clear? So in this way you will get many molecules. All the molecules will attract the molecules present at the center of sphere of influence, and also vice versa. That means this molecule will also attract all the other molecules. Okay? So this molecule will attract in this direction, in this direction, in this direction, in this direction. Okay? Clear? Clear? All the molecules present inside that sphere will attract the molecule present at the center of the sphere of influence. Okay? It will experience a force. So there are two kinds of forces. One is acting in the downward direction and the other is acting in the upward direction. Okay? Molecules present in the upper part of the sphere of influence will apply the force in the upward direction, and molecules present at the bottom surface of the sphere of influence will apply the downward force on the molecules present at the center of influence. So if these two forces, suppose I am dividing the whole region into two parts, this is the part I am dividing. So the molecules present at the upper surface will apply an upward force, resultant upward force. And molecules present at the downward surface will apply a downward force, resultant downward force. This is upward and this is downward. Okay, and if these two forces are equal, if these two forces are equal, then this molecule will be there. Okay, but if these two molecules are not same, then there will be a resultant force and this molecule will move towards the direction of resultant force. Clear? So this is sphere of influence. Okay, and the radius will be the range within this, the molecules present inside that sphere will apply a force on the sphere of influence, on the molecules present at the center of sphere of influence. Okay, now suppose if we take a water drop, a single water drop, and we place that water drop on any surface, okay, suppose at the floor, on the floor of the room or on the upper surface of table, then you will see that that water droplet is taking a particular shape, that is spherical shape. Okay, that water droplet is taking spherical shape. And remember that we are doing this thing when water or the liquid is at rest. Okay, so the water droplet is taking this shape, spherical shape. Spherical shape. And if you take a particular volume of that water, water means there is water molecules are there, that means particular volume is there. And if we take a particular volume, then only sphere is a particular kind of geometrical figure which will have minimum surface area. Okay, so for a particular volume, sphere has minimum surface area. Okay, among all the kind of geometrical figure, sphere has minimum surface area for a particular volume. For a particular volume, you can draw any kind of geometrical figure, sphere, cube, cuboid, any kind of. But sphere is a kind of geometrical figure which will have minimum surface area. Okay, so why it is taking minimum surface area? Why it is not taking any other kind of geometrical figure? Because there is a force acting. Suppose this is a water droplet, there is a force acting towards or inside the sphere. Okay, acting inside the sphere, and this force is always acting at the free surface of liquid. Okay, so here we can tell that the surface will be spherical and it will behave like a stretched membrane, because forces are there in all the direction along the surface. Forces are there. Okay, so forces are there means the free surface is in under tension. That means it will behave like a stretched membrane. Okay, so the free surface will behave like a stretched membrane. Okay, stretched membrane. And these forces which are acting along the surface of the liquid, okay, that force is called surface tension. Okay, surface tension. So due to this surface tension, what is happening? Due to this surface tension, any water droplet or any free surface of the liquid tends to gain minimum surface area. Okay, for any water droplet, any liquid droplet tends to gain minimum surface area. Okay, and such that the free surface of the liquid will behave like a stretched membrane. Clear? So I am writing its definition, surface tension. So how will you define it? So surface tension is basically, it is a property of liquid. It is a property of liquid at rest. Property of liquid at rest, by virtue of which, what will happen? The free surface of liquid tends to gain minimum surface minimum surface area. Minimum surface area such that the free surface will behave as a stretched membrane. Stretched membrane. Clear? So it is that kind of definition where it is telling that surface tension is a property of liquid. Okay, but I have already told surface tension is a force, okay, which is acting along the free surface of liquid. So we can measure the force. So there will be another definition which will tell about the measurement of surface tension. Okay, so what will be the definition related to the measurement of surface tension? That we will see now. How will you measure the surface tension? Okay, so I am erasing this. So students, now we will define surface tension in terms of its measurement. So how will you measure? So this is the free surface of liquid, suppose. Okay, this is the free surface of liquid. This is some liquid. Okay. So how will you measure? So surface tension is measured by the amount of force acting on unit length. Okay, we'll draw a unit length. This is the unit length. Okay, so surface tension is measured by the amount of force acting on unit length of line. But how the line will look like? So the line will be drawn tangentially at the free surface of liquid. At any point we can draw, but it will be tangent to the free surface of liquid. Clear? And the force will act on both the sides of this line. On both the sides of this line. And here, these forces will also be along the tangent of the free surface of liquid. Clear? So, how will you define it? So, surface tension is measured by the, it is measured by the amount of force acting on a unit length of line. How the line will look like? Drawn tangentially to free surface of liquid. Free surface of liquid. Okay. And the unit line can be anywhere, but it will look like this. Tangent and to the free surface of liquid. Tangent to the free surface of liquid. At any point on the liquid surface. Any point on the liquid surface. Okay. Clear. Now this force, what will be the nature of this force? Now this force will be perpendicular. Another important point. Perpendicular to this line. Okay. The force will be perpendicular. Few important points are there, those points you have to mention. You can write this definition in your language, it is fine. But you have to mention those points. I am mentioning those points. I will highlight those points. Okay, let me finish it. The force will be at right angle. Force will be at right angle to the unit length. Right angle to the unit length and tangent to the free surface of liquid. Clear? Just you have to mention all the points. Okay. It is measured by the amount of force. Okay. The important points I am circling. Amount of force acting on a unit length of line drawn tangentially, TA, tangentially to the free surface of liquid at any point on the liquid surface. The force will be at right angle to the unit length and tangent to the free surface of liquid. Okay, so these are the few points that you have to mention. You can write the definition in your language, that is fine, but you have to mention these points. Okay, so in this way we can measure surface tension. Another way is there to measure surface tension. I am coming to that point after some time. Okay, so here now we will see the unit of surface tension and its dimension. Okay, so now suppose this length is not of unit length, suppose at any length L. Okay, and the total amount of force acting on this line perpendicularly on both sides, okay, of that line and tangent to the free surface of liquid is suppose F. Okay, total force is F and the length of this line is L. Then what will be the surface tension? It is denoted by S. So the surface tension will be F by L. Okay, surface tension will be F by L. F is the total force acting on that line of length L. Okay, and the length will be, the property of that length will be this, tangential to the free surface of liquid drawn at any point on the liquid surface. Okay, so now we will see its unit and its dimension. And remember here, surface tension is a scalar quantity, not a vector. Okay, it is, although it is force by length, but it is a scalar quantity because there is no particular direction of force. Okay, if you take the line like this, okay, if you take the line like this, then the force will be like this. Okay, so there is no particular direction of this force. Okay, so it is a scalar quantity. So now I am coming to its dimension and unit. So we can write S equal to F by L. Okay, so it is this part. So its unit, first of all, unit will be what? Force by length. Force means newton, by length means meter inverse. Okay, SI unit is newton meter inverse. Clear? This is SI unit. CGS unit will be dyne centimeter inverse. CGS unit. Okay, dimension. So dimension will be, dimension means dimension of S equal to dimension of F by dimension of L. Dimension of F means force ML e to the power minus 2, and dimension of L is length, so L cancel out, so you will get ML0T-. Clear? So this is unit and dimension of surface tension. Clear? Now come to another thing, that is surface energy. Okay, I am erasing this. So now surface energy, this is very important part also, surface energy. Okay, surface energy. So here suppose that liquid drop will look like this. Okay, this is a liquid drop at rest. Okay, at rest. Clear? It look like a sphere. Okay, so now suppose you and the surface tensional force will act in this way. Okay, this is the surface tensional force acting inside the surface. Okay, and suppose you want to increase its shape and size, increase its size. Okay, so suppose you want to increase its size. Okay, that means it has a particular radius r, and you want to increase its radius to r plus delta. Okay, clear? So here for doing this, we have to apply some amount of force, okay, in the outward direction, because there is a force in the inward direction. Okay, so we have to apply an amount of force which is equal to this amount of force. Okay, in a minimum limit, the force will be equal to the force of surface tension. Okay, and we have to apply that force in the outward direction. Okay, and when we are applying that force in the outward direction, we are doing some amount of work done. Okay, against the surface tensional force. Clear? So that amount of work done will be stored at the free surface of liquid as its potential energy. Okay, so this is the work done. So surface energy is basically what? It is a work done. Okay, the work done is done by against the surface tensional force to increase or to change its size to a desired or given size at a particular temperature. Okay, here temperature point is very very important. So surface energy will be basically what? It is the amount of energy stored at the free surface of liquid. It is the amount of energy stored at the free surface of liquid when we are applying an amount of force, okay, at the free surface of liquid to change its surface by a particular or by a given quantity at a particular temperature. Clear? Clear? So I am writing its definition. So surface energy of a given liquid, surface energy of a given liquid of, change a little bit here, surface energy of free surface of a given liquid, because the energy will be stored at the free surface of a given liquid, free surface of a given liquid, okay, is defined as the amount of work done, as the amount of work done against the force of surface tension, against the force of surface tension, informing the liquid surface at a particular size or given size at a particular temperature. Okay, so surface energy of free surface of liquid, free surface of a given liquid, is defined as the amount of work done against the force of surface tension. This work done will be done against the force of surface tension, informing the liquid surface at a particular size at a particular temperature. Okay, so this is the definition of surface energy. Now we'll see its derivation, and then we will see the relation between surface energy and surface tension. Okay, so when there are different kinds of liquid surface, like if we take water surface, okay, or water droplet, then you will get only one free surface. That means we have to increase the size of one surface. But if we take soap bubble or soap film, okay, then you will get two surfaces. Okay, in case of soap bubble or soap film, you will get two surfaces. This is inner surface and this is outer surface. Here you will get soap molecules, okay, soap molecules, and in between these two spheres you will get water. Okay, so when we are increasing the surface area of one surface, then we have to increase the surface area of the second surface also. That means if we take soap bubble or soap film, this is soap bubble. So if we take soap bubble or soap films, then we have to increase two surface area. One is inner surface, another is outer surface. But if we take water drop, then we have to increase one surface area only. Okay, so here we have to understand, or we have to look at this point, so whether it is given soap bubble or water droplet. Soap bubble means two surface area, and water droplet means one surface area. Okay, here the increasing surface area of the outer surface will be equal to the increasing surface area of the inner surface. Okay, so when we are writing the increasing surface area for soap bubble, we'll write 2 into delta S. Delta S is what? Delta S is the change in surface area, any one, either inner or outer. Okay, we have to multiply it by 2. And in water droplet case, simply delta S is the change in area. Okay, clear? So now we'll see its derivation. So students, this is a metallic frame. A, B, C, D is a metallic frame. Okay, and here PQ is a wire which can slide along AB and CD. Okay, and BCQP, this one is a soap film or liquid film. Okay, whenever this word you will get film, okay, whether it is soap or liquid film, then you will understand there are two surfaces. Okay, two free surfaces. Okay, so for this case, when we are taking this PQ to P prime Q prime, that means we have to increase both the lengths because there are two surfaces. Okay, so when we are increasing the surface area of one, that means we have to increase the surface area of the second one also. Okay, so suppose I am taking here PQ is equal to L. Okay, PQ has length L. Okay, clear? Surface tensional force are acting in this way, okay, inside along the free surface of liquid, okay, free surface of that film. Okay, now this PQ is taken from this position to P prime Q prime, the dotted position, and the distance between these two is suppose delta x. Okay, clear? So what will be the change in area here? So change in area will be what? Change in area will be this area of this rectangle PQ Q prime P prime, that means L into delta X, right? But it is the surface change in surface area of one surface, but there are two surfaces, so we have to multiply by 2. Clear? So now this is length L. Okay, now according to the definition of surface tension, the amount of force will be surface tensional force. So surface tensional force will be what? S into L, but here 2 length will be there. Okay, at PQ 2 lengths are there, so S into 2L, this is the amount of force. Okay, and at the minimum, and for the minimum case, we have to apply this amount of force in the outward direction to increase its surface area. Okay, so when we are taking this PQ to P prime Q prime, the displacement is delta X. Okay, so work done W will be what? Force into displacement. So here force is S into 2L into delta X. Okay, that means we are getting S into 2L into delta X. So 2L into delta X means what? 2L into delta X means change in area. So when we are finding the work done, we can write in this way also. Okay, clear? Work done equal to surface tension, not force. This is surface tension, force per unit length, into delta A, change in area. Okay, and this amount of work done will be stored at the free surface of liquid as its surface energy. Okay, so surface energy E will be S into delta A. Okay, S into delta A. Clear? So in this way we have to find the total energy stored in that free surface of liquid. Okay, so what are the quantities we need? We need surface tension and changing area. Okay, we need surface tension and changing area, not only area, changing area. Okay, so from this thing we can define the surface tension also, that is S equal to E by delta A. Okay. So if delta is 1, then S will be equal to surface energy or the work done, right? So from this point we can also define the surface tension. So surface tension of a liquid is basically what? Okay, I am erasing this portion. Okay, I am erasing. So surface tension of a liquid is the amount of work done against the force of surface tension in increasing its surface area by unity, and here not to forget write this point, at constant temperature. Okay, clear? That means here if delta A is equal to 1, then we get surface tension is basically work done or surface energy. So surface tension of a liquid is the amount of work done against the force of surface tension in increasing its surface area by unity. Okay, by unity at constant temperature. Clear? Clear? Yeah. Okay. So here also you can see E is the energy, that means scalar quantity. Delta area scalar quantity. So surface tension is a scalar quantity. Clear? So using that surface energy formula, we will solve now one small numerical so that you can understand, okay, how to solve. So I'm erasing this. So this is one numerical related to that surface energy formula. Write this formula here. That is energy equal to surface tension into change in area. Okay, here change in area. It may be 2 into delta A, okay, or it may be only delta A. This is, don't write delta A, write change in area. Change in area. If it is film, liquid film or soap film, then we have to take 2 into delta A. Okay. So here it is given rectangular film. Okay. First read the question properly. Rectangular film. Film means two surface area. A liquid is extended from this to this. So area is changing from this to this. This is the final area, that is the initial area. So what will be the change in area first of all? Okay, so change in area first of all. Change in area. So it is film. Film means 2. 2 into. 2 into. Final area. Final area. 6 into 5. It is in centimeter. So converted into meter into 10 to the power centimeter square. 2 meter square. 10 to the power minus 4. Minus 5 into 3. Into 10 to the power minus 4. This is in meter square. So this is change in area. Okay. So calculate this. 2 into what will be? 30 minus 15 into 10 to the power minus 4 meter square. You will get basically 15 into 2. 30. 30 into 10 to the power minus 4 meter square. Clear? Here work done is given. Work done is given. Work done is the energy. Okay, work done means the energy is given. So energy is given E equal to S into change in area. Change in area. Okay, so here E is given. How much? 3 into 10 to the power minus 4 equal to S into change in area means 30 into 10 to the power minus 4. Okay. So 10 to the power minus 4, 10 to the power minus 4 cancelled out. So S will be 3 by 30. Okay. That means you will get 0.1. 0.1. What will be its unit? Unit of surface tension. Unit of surface tension means force by length. That means Newton meter inverse. We are doing this in SI system. So Newton meter inverse. Don't forget to write the unit. Okay. So this is a kind of numerical, okay? So here you have to read the question and understand whether it is given film, okay, liquid film or liquid drop. If it is given liquid film, then two surface. If it is given liquid drop, then one surface. Clear? So this is our first class of surface tension. Okay.